Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Excellencies, ministers, Assalamu alaikum and good morning. I would like to first of all thank the US government for convening this leaders' dialogue at a very critical time for our planet. Pakistan is a country which contributes less than 1% to the global emissions, but yet it is one of the countries which is on the top 10 list of most vulnerable countries because of our topography and our geography. We face the Himalayan glaciers which are melting in the north of Pakistan, the arid zones of Pakistan which are getting heat waves like never before, cyclones in the south and sea level rise and floods in the floodplains. All of these compendium of natural disasters, the frequency and the intensity of these disasters have gone up by climate change and they are impacting 220 million people. So Pakistan is really at the forefront of this climate disaster. But yet we are a strong and resilient nation which is trying to cope with this disaster. In Pakistan, we are planting 10 billion trees and restoring over 1 million hectares of forest, including the mangroves in the south. Today, Pakistan is the only country in the world with an increasing mangrove cover. We are increasing our protected areas and we are trying to use our flood water judiciously and effectively through the Recharge Pakistan initiative, which is going to use this flood water to recharge our aquifer and also restore our degraded wetland systems. Also, Pakistan has committed itself to a green and a clean energy pathway. Although we can take the other route, which is a low-cost route, but it is a polluting route and harmful for the world. We have committed ourselves to 60% clean energy by 2030 and 30% electric vehicle transition by 2030. So Pakistan is clearly doing more than its share for the climate change issue. Also, at the end, I would like to say that the world really needs to get off this war path with nature. This is not a sustainable pathway. It will only get us into further trouble. The world needs to do more on climate change. It needs to do more on actual climate action and not just words. Action on the ground needs to be taken now. And the world needs to do more on climate finance. It needs to deliver climate finance for countries in energy transition like Pakistan, for countries who need to adapt again like Pakistan to climate change. And it needs to honor the commitment of $100 billion a year that has been promised on climate finance. I think the world does not have a choice but to go this pathway. And Pakistan is totally committed to an inclusive, cooperative, and collaborative pathway towards this end. Thank you very much.